Hi everybody. Today I'm gonna do an update, just a little update on Molly because she had her 4 month checkup yesterday. So her appointment was on Thursday, April 10th. And she's right here, she's awake and all that, so I'll show her off to you. She's like, "Oh yeah, I'm gonna eat my hands." So before I forget, I want to tell everybody that how it went. Finally the weather was warm enough that we were able to walk there. So I put her in her stroller. My mom came over. I wanted my mom to come over. It's not her day off, but she works from home on Thursday. So she came over and we pushed her in the stroller because the clinic that we go to is like right on the corner. So we were able to walk there. It took us, I don't know, like 15, 20 minutes to walk there, and it was really hot outside. I was like burning up. And it was a pretty warm day. So we got there and like waited, and then we went back in the room, and there's like a resident, I don't know what they're called exactly, but like someone that's training to be like a general practitioner or something who is, you know, either a nurse, whatever she's doing, she's like in training. And so she got to pick Molly up and like do some of the stuff. She said that developmentally she's like a little bit ahead, which is really cool. I think she said that because Molly stands up like she stands up on her legs. I know you can't see her legs, but I promise she's standing on her own. She just sat down. Stand up. Like, I'm not holding her. Well, she doesn't feel like standing right now, but she stands, she's really strong, she doesn't have any head lag. When they did the head lag thing, she has no head lag at all anymore, so I was like, yeah. And she's looking around, smiling, giggling, cooing and stuff. She started laughing again like the other day, and now she laughs a lot, and it was just really, really fun. So she'll turn down this way. And she's been doing a lot of cool stuff lately that I'll do in my 5 month update. But they weighed her, and I thought she weighed at least 13 pounds. She weighs 14.9 pounds. I'm not sure if that's 9 ounces or like 90% of the weight of 15. I think it's 9 ounces. So she weighs like 14 and a half pounds. That's how much Eenie weighed at her heaviest. So Molly officially weighs as much as Eenie. And so I'm trying to get her to stand. She won't do it. She knows she's being filmed. So yeah, she weighs like 14 and a half pounds. I feel every pound. Oh, hi, baby. Hi, sweetie. She has been talking a lot more and stuff lately, also. So yes, 14 and a half pounds, and she is 25 and one quarter inches long. She has grown almost 6 inches since she was born. She was 20 inches when she was born, although like at the hospital 2 days later at her pediatrician, she was 19 and a half inches. So I don't know exactly how long she was when she was born, but now she's 25 and a quarter. And I think her head circumference is like 16 and a half centimeters, I think is what it is. But she is spitting up, and she is getting really big. She's huge. And that put her in the 52nd percentile for weight and the 75th percentile for height. So she is tall and skinny. She's got skinny legs. She does have little rolls in her legs, but only like one. She's not a very chunky baby. And like at her checkup 2 months ago, she was in the 50th percentile for both. So she has gotten taller than she has gained weight. So she's right now she's tall and skinny. So that's where she is at 4 months old. I think she's like almost 19 weeks old. I think that's where she's at. I don't remember. I don't count weeks anymore because after like 15 weeks, it's like no one counts weeks. Actually, after 12 weeks, nobody counts weeks. So, yeah, this is kind of a derpy vlog, but oh, and the cabinet's open, of course. Okay, so this morning, or actually when I got home from work, I went to get some waffles out of the freezer because we have Eggo waffles, and I noticed that the breast milk I have in there, one of the things was frozen and one of the bags was not frozen at all, and I was like, oh crap. And so I was like, is our freezer not freezing? And then I felt the popsicles in there and they're slushy, and I was like, oh crap. And there's a giant sheet of ice on the back wall of our freezer, so I know that's what it is, but I was like, dang it, our freezer's not freezing anymore. And so it's not broken. What happens is when condensation gets on your freezer element in the back, it gets a sheet of ice, and when that ice gets thick enough, it actually insulates that, and so the cold won't leave, and so that actually makes your freezer warm up. I know that because we have a big upright freezer that our families own that they left here, and every 2 years it has to be thawed because. Or defrost, de-thawed. It has to be defrosted, and so I know that. So I'm kind of annoyed that that's happened, but thankfully they left a fridge, freezer, and a freezer in our garage when my parents moved. So I turned on, I plugged in the, they're unplugged, so we don't use them right now. I plugged in the fridge, freezer. So it should be cold by this evening, and I can take out the things that are still frozen and put them in there and stuff, and then work on chiseling the ice away because this is indoors, so I can't just let it melt all over the floor. My Molly girl's in a really good mood. Wow, she's talking. Oh, you're coughing and talking and stuff. Say hi. Oh yeah, and the most important part, she got her second set of shots yesterday. And I was really nervous because I thought she was gonna cry really hard and it was gonna make me cry. But she surprised me a lot. She barely cried at all. She didn't start crying until the doctor was pretty much done with the first shot. And then by the time she started to really cry, the nurse was done. And she got 3 shots and she got an oral syrup vaccine. So by the time the nurse, or by the time Molly started really crying, the nurse was done. And so I picked her up and she immediately stopped crying. She cried for 30 seconds max. And it wasn't even tears crying. It was just she didn't even really scream. She just kind of cried loudly for 30 seconds. And then she was fine. And I was like, holy crap, whoa. And then she started crying, but it was her I'm tired cry because she was due for a nap. And so we put her in her back in her stroller, and then when we got discharged and stuff, we left. And she fell asleep on the walk home and slept for a while, so she was totally fine. She didn't even care. So I'm hoping she inherited our high pain tolerance. I never really cried during shots. As a teen, at least. As a kid, I did, and I was really embarrassed that I cried, actually. So yeah, she was great. She looks awesome. They said I could start solids now or wait till 6 months, and I said I'm waiting till 6 months because then I don't have to change stinky diapers for 2 more months, which is my biggest motivation, and also it's recommended. So I'm gonna wait till she's 6 months old before I give her solids. I want her to be sitting out before I give her solids, basically. So there's the joking reason and a legitimate reason. So no solids for her this month. Maybe some tastes of stuff, but definitely no solids. I don't know why she's mad. I think she just wants to be held. Yeah. Or she's gonna be tired. Okay, so anyway, we're gonna go before she gets really mad. She likes to blow raspberries and fuss. It's really funny. So, okay, before you get mad, say bye. Say bye. Bye bye.
Bye.